Welcome back, everybody, here to your Russian DOTA 2 League coverage. Virtus Pro going up against No Tidehunter in what is now our final deciding matchup. That is right, it's game number 3 of the winner's bracket first semi-final. Who will get their position in that winner's bracket final first? We'll find out over the course of the next, however, no minutes. With Virtus Pro over on the Dire side this time around, over on the Radiant side will be No Tidehunter, and they're starting off. It was banned in game number 2. It was picked up in game number 1 and used by a very, very effective term. Wow. Grammar, language. Ah! He was used very effectively by Virtus Pro with their normal combination with the CK. In this scenario, though, No Tide have the Wisp. Will they combine them up with the CK? We'll go with the Nakes instead. So Nakes and Darkseer will be there for S4. And with this lineup, I'm wondering if Virtus Pro to say, well, okay, well, we're dealing already now with the Nakes. We're probably going to have to worry about team fight with the Darkseer. Do we just go in for the mag pickup? They banned out the Chen. They banned out the Prophet. They're taking out the split push possibility as far as momentum goes. But they're not taking out that global control, though. It's two different things we're looking at. I can't remember who it was. I was having a discussion with this the other day. But it came down to basically comparing Wisp as well as Nature's Prophet and these two heroes and how they actually like bring a presence into this global control kind of push strat, which we see more and more. In fact, it's probably the most dominating strat across all of Europe right now. When you see the Nature's Prophet, he TPs into a lane, kills off the creep wave, and then leaves his tree army to push it out. Where you have Wisp who will TP in with somebody else looking for a gank, maybe to push out a creep wave as well, but not really. It's meant to be to kill off heroes. So it's two different types of global control. One is a pain in the absolute ass when it comes to just trying to keep your map control, and the other one is a pain in the ass by just wanting to venture out and be on the map. So when you put them two together and you've got no map control, and then you've also got a team that love to make the most out of it when they've got aggressive warding, then they can gank up, they use this Wisp, they gank themselves around. The two of them together are almost unstoppable. But that's why most teams went out one or the other. So Nature's Prophet being removed, Wisp being removed, Keeper of the Light as well as Nyx being removed out here by S4. So no Keeper of the Light going to come the way of us. But there is a Rubick on the field. Normally would throw that towards KSI, but KSI, with the inclusion now of Arsat in the Virtus Pro lineup, KSI goes on to the lone druid's third position role. So it still keeps Crazy in the middle lane, puts Illidan on the hard carry. And it could be either Arsat or NS's Rubick. And we start going through our final bans now. So S4's options. Bans out hard carry, or bans out another supporter. That's the only other options he's got. So he takes out the Luna to start with. And who else of Virtus Pro? Gyro is still available in the pool too. Another favorite of Illidan's. Don't know if you'd 100% go with the... it'll still be worth it. It'll still be worth it. We'll still synergize decently with the rest of Virtus Pro lineup. If they pick up something like, what else would they want? We've got ganking here, so they're looking for another stunner. Lashrak would be a pickup here by Virtus Pro. Combines up nicely with Rubick to get the double stun. Also combines up nicely with the Lone Drill when they look to push out the towers very early on. But S4 can't decide. But we'll see if he takes out the Lashrak plus the Gyro. Will be what I think S4 is probably tossing up right now. And then through the Virtus Pro lineup, they're just wanting to ban out the mid-solos. You've already got a Darkseer long lane. It doesn't matter what supporter. No time to have to go with the Wisp. It's a pretty low aggression on the lane. They should take out the Juggernaut. Interesting. They're a little bit more concerned about that hard carry Juggernaut with the healing ward to push down the towers early on. NS already knows what he wants. And the PL, too. Ooh, okay. Some hatred towards all the hard carries. Screw the little Shrek. And VP last here in the mid lane. Mag will be the ban. And then Gyro pick up instantly from S4. So that explains why he doesn't ban out the Gyro. Takes out all the other hard carries instead. And with that Gyro pickup, it screws our lanes up even more. I say it screws up our lanes like I'm talking like I'm one of these teams. No, it screws up overall-wise because Gyro now, we can look to see him go towards the middle lane. Which means it becomes S4's Gyro. Loader onto that Naked on the safe lane with the Wisp. Darkseer can start on that top lane depending on the hard carry of Virtus Pro. May not feel too much confidence when Rubick is up here. And with these two BKB heroes, I'm wondering if Virtus Pro go back to Crazy's Beastmaster. Get that level 6 roar up him very, very quickly so they get a lockdown for the Nakes and the Gyro. We go for a Weaver instead. Of course, if you look through the No Titan lineup, where are the stuns? Where are the stuns? You got Wisp with a tether, and you got Gyro with a homing missile. So we're looking at the level of control here on Weaver is nothing. This will force a very early Orchid out in somebody. Be it the mid solo, if we go for something like a... No, Queen of Pain is taken out, Puck's taken out, Mag's taken out. All these big controllers are completely gone. What is S4? What else can he pick up here in the middle lane that will give that level of control over a Weaver? He needs a stun and he's going to pick up an SK. So supporting SK. Difficult to catch out the Weaver. Even in the early stages, that level 1 Burrow Strike is just so short. Weaver will just run circles around the SK. Even that bottom lane, like, Weaver's going to have a great time if he goes long lane. But it's KSI on the lone Druid. We've got both Rubick as well as Lina. So it'll be NS who takes up the Rubick. And it'll be us out over on Lina. And as predicted, Loaded would be on the Nakes. S4, in fact, is going to take up the Darkseer. So it'll be an Admiral Bulldog on the Gyro. And that leads it to be an aggressive trial line up on the top. Aki support as the SK, AGM supporting Wisp. They might try and stick it to the man up here on the top lane. I'm only saying that because, like, seeing a long lane Gyro just doesn't fit. No, they switch it. Admiral Bulldog now up on the Nakes. Yeah. They changed their mind. So Loda will take the hard carry Gyro down to the bottom lane. And they're already drawing the line. So maybe they feel the aggressive lane by VP, which would not surprise me at all. Illidan onto the Weaver. So not a long lane. He'll be here with Arsa as well as NS. Level 1 team fight here from Virtus Pro is quite decently strong. In comparison to the No Titan lineup where you got, what, a Burrow Strike, a Tether level 1, so no Spirits, a lot of Rocket Barrage, something to be fearful of, but Admiral Bulldog, he'll go Open Wounds or he'll go Rage. Either way, he only has one point of either control or stability. Now, one Napalm stack, in they go. Weaver, Shookies through 3. Lifestrike Array also on a couple. Burrow Strike will happen, but S4 too low on life. He's being focused down by the Weaver. In fact, it's Arsene who'll take the first blood. And it's another Lifestrike Array by Arsene. He's hit two big ones. They lose the Wisp, so it's 1-2 right now. Illidan wants to get through to somebody. Gets blocked inside the tree line. A third Lifestrike Array coming out from Arsene, giving a double kill over to Illidan. It's 3-1 on the board for that. TP's being purchased to come back to the bottom lane as quickly as possible. But one kill for the Wisp, who also died. That's why he had the money to buy a TP and come back, but that was instantly thrown away. And Arsene and Weaver take the others. So a kill for Lina, kill for Illidan. The first blood did go to Lina, though, which means bonus gold. And they look for more. They look for another setup. And Aki, you can see him try and Burrow Strike through, but instantly he did so. So far in death. And Darkseer, S4, dying this early on. I suppose for him, he'll be happy he spent all this cash. They're trying to D-ward. Radiant Side will throw it down. There's a Sentry Ward here from NS, but he's not going to throw it just yet. They want to clean off these heroes first before they do it. But it won't take him too long to work out where that ward is. It's this Battle of the Pull. They just throw a Sentry Ward smack bang in the middle of the camp. And the Sentry Ward of the Radiant Side is too far over now. Loader, homing missile, going to go out in Arsene. They're following through, so it's going to be an SK Burrow Strike to start up here on NS. And then Line Strike Array, trying to slow down EGM, pick up, throw down. So the extra AoE stun is almost enough, but it is enough to kill off that Wisp. And now Loader, he's going to get Line Strike Array again. There's no Tidehunter. One kill up the other. It's a good Burrow Strike, and now by a little bit more space, tethering in. But Illidan, he's trying to look for the Generator attack. He needs a couple more levels up in that before he can bring somebody down, but he just keeps the rest of no Tidehunter low on life. Arsene's got himself another Light Strike Array. They're trying to heal up here on the bottom lane, bring Loader back up to a proper life point. Your GM not tethering up against it, Lotus not getting that effect of the tango charge. But it's a great trail line of VP working out beautifully. And Arsak, superb play as Leaner on the bottom. He really deserves more than two levels. In fact, they all do on this bottom lane. But it's better than the two supports, so no Tide. So they will deep ward out the secondary sentry. But they still didn't get that 2 minute camp to spawn up. And all VP have to do is just rotate over in 50 seconds time and body block it out. Crazy, how's he looking in the middle lane? So 12 for 6 up against an 8 for nil S4. Is that the bottle now coming out in the courier? Yeah, it is. And up towards top lane, Admiral Bulldog. 5 for 1 up against a lone druid, who is now 9 for 0. Admiral Bulldog probably wouldn't mind getting a last hit in this bear, but the chance of KSI giving that very, very minimal. NS as well as Arsak coming in again. And Loader again, having to deal with this as opposed to trying to contest the farm on the lane with Illidan. Illidan's just got to stay on top of those denials in the bottom lane. They can reduce this experience of the aggressive tri-lane, the defensive tri-lane from no Tidehunter, then this lane will just get out of control in favor of VP. And this bear continues to beat down Admiral Bulldog, but Admiral Bulldog likes this. This is a good lane for a lifestealer. If he gets to level 6 and has that extra little bit of insurance to make sure he doesn't die, then this lane's quite fine for him. So you see him with the 2 points up in Feast, 6% of the enemy's current HP. So he takes 6% of 2,300. Makes for a very, very good lane. Well, taking out the rockets again. I'm not going to stop NS from being hit. Oh, crazy. Invis rune, Firefly damage up on S4. As he have a flame break, pushing back in again. Nice little play by Crazy. He'll have to bullet charge quickly to survive up against the tower. Nope, he'll be fine. But solo kill up on that mid. Okay, yes, at level 5. So this entangle is here. So this is why I'm saying the EMFS needs to be here for next, just in case he drops down too low after he gets entangled. But 5 for 1 now in favor of Virtus Pros. So the advantage this time goes their way at the start of the game. Still need to transition into a little bit more. That's the Admiral Bulldog now going level on the farm in the mid. But not for long. Crazy comes up. Back of a haste rune. He'll just lasso and hold. Lasso. Yep, there it goes. He was just waiting for the rage. Drags him a long, long way back here. And his death. KSI will take it. Keeps the control in all the lanes. And now they go on the bottom. No, maybe not. Illidan just being a little bit more aggressive with his Shooky. Buy some space for the supports. Level 3 is now up. So 2 points up. Starting to level up the Slave instead of going up for the Light Strike Array. Sun duration doesn't change. It's the extra 60 damage. Whoa! Weaver, already a long way down. Loader's going to be taken here. Illidan, no time-lapse available. He doesn't really need it. Now Admiral Bulldog starting up here at Arsak. It's just going to be a support for a support. Sentry Wars drop down, so Aki nowhere to hide. And Illidan just keeps on attacking it. So Aki will go down in one area. And Arsak able to limp himself away here from Admiral Bulldog. Pick up, throw down. Line Strike Array was only just on the edge to get that follow-up stun. Illidan won't care about the rage. It's physical damage he wants to deal right now. And he will do it. Double kill for Illidan. First rotation now by Admiral Bulldog after he dies up on the top lane to rotate bottom lane to try and be involved in a 4v3 fight. And VP take a 4v3 fight, which gives now even more space to KSI on the top lane. He'll have a resummon in a moment and they'll bring down the tier 1 tower. And everything is not coming up roses anywhere. Crazy gets involved in the top fight, still higher levels, S4. Sure, his CS is looking a little bit better. But I got a funny feeling he also jumped himself inside the jungle for that. You see the top 3 net worths. The 3 cores again of VP, very similar to game. Well, actually it was game number 2, wasn't it, for No Tide, they're taking all the farm. But this time it's coming for different reasons. 5 kills, 2 assists currently on Illidan. Builds the Perseverance. Gonna build into his treads next. And then we'll finish the job, and there goes NS. Crazy. Oh, bottle timing? Doesn't have any bottle charges? 8 HP he survives on. Oh, that's going to be frustrating. He'll have to go all the way back to base, but he won't really care. He still gets the kill on the Darkseer and doesn't lose his own life. And Rubble Dog returns to the top lane. Still no level 6 up on him yet. In the meantime, KSI is 7.5. Phase Boots on himself, which I'm pretty sure he's been switching with his bear. And as with an Invis Rune. Looking for that setup, an EGM dead. Now pick him up, the same time Illidan's gonna arrive, so pick him up. Attack a little bit harder, he'll try and tether away to safety, but there's just not enough time. Even with 2 points in Fade Bolts, more than enough burst damage. That's NS who takes the last hit. He already has his boots, 10 stick charges up his sleeve. And just keep taking out support after support here on the bottom lane, as well as carry. Oh, trouble for Admiral Bulldog. Getting damaged down a little bit. See how aggressive VP are going to get. It's coming nice and close. Wow, that slave threw a little bit faster in the air. Aki just chilling. He's level 2. He's level 2 on a tri-lane, which normally isn't that bad, but when you see the supports of at 5 and 4 on the opposing tri-lane and the carries up at 6, Loader's at level... not even level 5, he's just short of it. And EGM, stunned up. Aki's trying to come back to help him, but this is a Wisp taking unnecessary damage. He's got no extra consumables. So his spirits, he's trying to return some love into Arsat. As they just keep looking for this support combination. 3 points Fade Bolt, so now more burst damage for VP. And middle lane, are we going again? Crazy standing nice and close. Bolt charging up, his Blink Dagger. Very, very close. 8 minute rune, and it's a haste rune for the top too. So he'll rotate top lane again and kill off the Nakes. Or is it? No. NS as well as Arsat have rotated in towards the mid. They're looking for this. They're looking for S4 to be doing exactly what he's doing. Crazy doesn't want to go to the top lane. He doesn't have Firefly, but he'll pop the Haste Rune. So the Bear starts off, trying to bring down Admiral Bulldog. Napalm, he can hold off. Ah, there's an Infest. He's in the range creep too. Trying to kill it off as quickly as possible. Now he jumps out. Lasso pulls him back. Weaver kills off the Wisp on the bottom lane in the meantime. But we'll stick with the Admiral Bulldog fight up here on the top lane. Two heroes just slowly whittling him down. And now back down towards the bottom. Looks like Aki's the only one left remaining. Wisp gonna TP in. TP in by S4. Light Strike to raid up. Is there a Laguna Blade level? Not just yet, but the back in. Too much damage. Illidan goes wicked sick down here on the bottom lane. Aki gets to live. But he's got not enough mana. He's trying to TP out. Illidan will find him and almost enough damage to kill him off before the TP finished. The Shooky damage was pretty damn high. Up at level 4 it is. But even then, Shikuchki. See, I can't say it right. Shikuchki. I just think of Kuchki Clan. Sorry, Bleach. You screw with me on that one. I'd say it's Shooky as a short. Be you lovers or haters. That's just how it works, guys. That's a tier 1 tower in the bottom lane. Be your lover or hater right now when it's 1-15 on the scoreboard. You're definitely going to say VP. Yep. Yep. Advantage. And then Arcane Boots as well for NS. With the extra clarities, Blink Daggers on Batriders. VP have all they need to just keep on pressuring this out. Weaver's almost about to forward up his own ultimate orb. T1 tower was taken by on the top lane by KSI. He looks like with this kind of build, he's just going to rush himself up to having a nice Radiance. And KSI, ultimate form. Oh, he's going to need some help right now if he wants to live through this cooldown. They're throwing everything they've got to kill off KSI, but there's a lot of support rotating up the middle end. They still haven't managed to bring him down just yet. Now they get the kill. Admiral Bulldog's on the run, and in comes Crazy. Is he going to last through? He does do so. Just holding Admiral Bulldog there, but now it's VP who are throwing the lives away, but maybe not. Yeah, it is. It's a double kill for Illidan. S4 to go. Triple kill for Illidan. They killed off the Batrider, and they killed off the Lone Druid. Lone Druid, the initial person to die, and then Batrider's like, well, I got this lasso. I can hold Loader here. Everybody just come over the mountainside and then kill him off. And they came over the mountainside. The tri-lane again. They were the powerhouse in that. Batrider did very, very little apart from hold Loader in one position for a little bit longer. The rest of it just came through the supports. 2 points to the Burrow Strike stolen by NS. And they're 4 points up in the Dragon Slave. Huge area of damage. Illidan, he really wants this tower. There's TP supports coming in to try and stop him. S4 staying very, very close. Now, whoop, Burrow Strike in. Is there a pickup? There is. It's going to drop back down again, but already too much life being lost here by NS. There's going to be the cost of S4's life. The Firefly was down. They're finding the middle of it. Weaver able to catch the Wisp inside the tree line. Admiral Baldock now also not going to be so lucky. The Slave will fly, but Elden right behind him. Another double kill. What the? He's 12 for nil. He's getting more than one kill a minute. His team is getting two kills a minute. And they're taking map control. They're taking towers. That's a Lincoln Sphere done. Yep, Lincoln Sphere done. Flying out now. Kuchki. Now I want to call it Kuchki. Now Kuchki. The Kuchki clan. Chikuchki. Chikuchki. So I'm reading the chat where you guys are talking about it now. There's that armlet as well. Armlet for a KSI's bear. So that's his decision. Screw the Radiance. They know they already have a lot of control. They want to do more damage right now. And no tide. They probably want to just do what they tried to do before. It almost kind of felt like an all-in, but not with every single chip on the table, which didn't make it an all-in. Hey! Well, one smoke is not enough. These are addicted smokers right here. So we have a five-minute break at the end of every single game while they go at smoke. KSI, again, giving the man to be caught out. Reveals off Admiral Baldock. They move themselves back. They've got sentry wards here too, so they see exactly what's coming in. Admiral Baldock picked up. Fade bolted. Line Strike Array won't be able to combo. And you got the Rage off in time and then call down. Well, homing missile is what was actually stolen at the end of the day. Focusing on Loader out of all this. But it's a good fight for No Tide. Everyone grouped up, but then Illidan able to time-lapse. And now it's a horrible fight for No Tidehunter. They'll lose one after the other. S4 is held in position. It's a double kill for Illidan. And he's about to make it a triple kill. Picking up Egham. A quick tether. But already S4 calls out the GG. A 15-0 Weaver will carry this through. No Tide showed in game number two they can still stand up against Virtus Pro. They showed in game number one that even doesn't matter how much advantage, they'll still end up losing it. Crazy. Is he denying the bear? Yeah, he is. KSI doesn't have a resummon yet. Oh, I don't care. But our next game's coming up. We're going to head ourselves over to the EMS1 Raid Call Spring Cup. The second last group stage to be played out tonight. And No Tidehunter will be the team we'll follow through most of the evening. Should be some interesting matches. We'll be doing No Tide versus DD. Infinity Gaming. Sorry, Infinite Black Gaming, I think it is. And then Rat. Infinite Gaming Black. And then the last one, which is Rat. The team from Finland that managed to get their way through. They will be the final team in that group of four. Looks like, there we go, finally Darkseer will DC himself back out again. So we'll get ourselves over that tournament. Carl will be joining me for that broadcast, so we'll be having ourselves some fun together on the live stream, so stick around. It got ourselves at least three more best, well I say at least, we will have a guaranteed three best of ones coming your way, so six games in total for tonight. We get the full three from this best of three series. Now, if you missed any of the games from this evening, there will be a rebroadcast a little bit later on tonight. The end of the last game will start up the rebroadcast, or you can just head yourself over to youtube.com/joindota, where we upload all the VODs and then, of course, tie them into our database over on joindota.com. So everything is connected. Everything is connected. It's like the circle of life. Everything is connected. All right, let's get ourselves into our next game. That was 14 minutes and 50 seconds. Probably get ourselves about 30 minutes before the next game will start off, so stick around the live stream as always. We'll drop and restart again as we switch over from our different coverages, but we will be back here for your viewing pleasure with more Dota 2 action.